What it dooski YouTube, it's your boy Mine and Malcolm, and I'm back today with a highly anticipated video on honestly one of my favorite silhouettes when it comes to Jordan brand. If the title hasn't given away already, we're going to be talking about Maniére's latest collaboration with Jordan brand on the Air Jordan 1. And if you can remember, just a few months ago, I was talking about the Air Jordan 3 collaboration they had, and that release was crazy, easy sneaker of the year contender for me, and a lot of you watching this as well. With that in mind, today let's take a closer look at the latest collaboration from Maniére to see if it lives up to the hype or if they just missed the mark with the second release. Once again, before all that, like the video if you like the video, subscribe if you're new, and welcome to the channel, and follow your boy on Instagram to catch me in between videos and really see what's going on when I'm not on YouTube. Nevertheless, super excited about today's video, so let's go, let's get into it. Unlike the last Air Jordan and Maniére collaboration, this time they actually opted to give us a full size run when it came to sizing, meaning men's, women's, as well as kids in preschool. If you can remember, for the Air Jordan 3 release, it was actually a women's exclusive, which is cool because a lot of the people who usually get neglected when it comes to footwear had a better chance. But for people like me, I had to go on the extended sizing. But this time around, thankfully, the Air Jordan 1 was a lot more obtainable because there was multiple releases. The first one is the one I actually hit on, which is on the Maniére website on November 24th. Pretty easy release. The second release was more worldwide. It was actually on December 3rd, a couple of days ago. So the usual sneaker boutiques, as well as Sneakers Canada, also got those. So hopefully you hit on one of those. But if not, there is a lot of hope because on the resale market, they are not going for a super high price. But we'll talk about that later in today's video. Similar to the last release, Maniére did not pull any stops when it came to designing their shoe or the overall theme around that. And that includes the box. So as you can see, this is not your everyday regular Air Jordan 1 box. It does come with the plastic sheath or covering. Actually, just an Maniére logo all around, similar to the Jordan 3. And it is a box that resembles all the colors of the shoe. Those actually being burgundy and this nice sail colorway. You will find the usual Nike hit on the top of the box and Maniére and Jumpman logos all around the sides. The official colorway of the shoe reads sail and burgundy crush. And that's something you're definitely going to see permeating through all of the branding around this release. And inside the box, there is some cool details as well. If you were to pull up the box top, you actually see right away there is an Maniére and Jumpman hit in the iconic pose in a burgundy colorway. Inside the box, you're going to find the usual Maniére branded paper alongside some waxed sail laces and a Maniére and Jumpman hang tag in cracked leather, very reminiscent of the upper of the whole shoe. And now the moment we've all been waiting for, the shoe itself. And first impressions, honestly, I like the shoe a lot. I'm not sure if it's gonna be as much as the Air Jordan 3 release because that had a lot of hype and it really lived up to it, but this is my favorite Jordan silhouette. And so far, this looks like a solid shoe, but let's break it down. Starting with the upper, which is comprised of cracked leather in a sail colorway, and definitely not something I'm used to seeing on an Air Jordan 1. It was really cool to see James Whitner in a recent interview with GQ, and he mentioned that while going through the design process, he kind of had the ideas picked out in terms of inspiration, but halfway or kind of three quarters through, they actually scrapped the design in sense of materials. So it was initially gonna be tumbled leather, but then at the last moment, they opted for the cracked leather. And I'm definitely glad they did because it's not something you see every day. And it's definitely not something you see on Air Jordan 1s regularly. The last time I can think of them using this type of material would be on the taupe haze Jordan 4 release that came out this past winter, which I did enjoy as well. Holding it in hand, it's already kind of shedding, if that makes sense, just because I'm grabbing it so much. But when you have it on foot, I don't think that's going to be such a problem because you won't actually be touching the upper yourself. And when it comes to the overall theme of the shoe, this one I would consider definitely more for family. And by that, I mean the main kind of drivers behind the inspiration are luxury goods, the black community as a whole, or black culture, as well as the community James Whitner grew up in. And the burgundy hits actually signify the blood of the people that meant a lot to him and kind of the surrounding cultures. So it's not your everyday, regular Jordan release with just some bland colors. When you take a closer look at the upper, that's where you're gonna see a lot of the more subtle details come to light. First things first, obviously, being the burgundy swoosh. So if you take a closer look, it's actually in that snakeskin pattern, but sorry to let you down, it is not textured. It's actually just a print. With that being said, there's no real texture to it like the rest of the shoe, which is cracked leather and you can really feel. But I totally get it. When it comes to a general release shoe, if you're going to use premium materials such as actual snakeskin leather, that's gonna cost a pretty penny. Well, pennies don't even exist anymore, it's weird to say. So I'm not mad at that at all in that burgundy and kind of squared off pattern all around the swoosh and the heel collar of the shoe, as well as underneath the actual eye stay. In typical Jordan 1 fashion, you're gonna find a perforated toe box which has the same material as the rest of the upper, being that cracked sail leather, complemented by some sail stitching as well. Moving up to the tongue, there's two lacing options as I mentioned at the start of the video. First one being the wax burgundy option, the second one being the wax sail option. Cool thing to note though, Both of these actually have metal lace tips with the Alma Maniére branding as well. So definitely pushing into that luxury realm as you would get with more designer shoes or more expensive shoes. The tongue itself is composed of fully cracked leather, which is cool. And in terms of details on the tongue tag, you're going to see the Alma Maniére branding as well as the typical Nike Air hit. Moving on to the guts of the shoe is where you'll find the quilted satin liner, which is all in the burgundy colorway, which matches the insole. And in terms of kind of disruptions, there is a black tag on the insole that's sewn in. And it reads Airness by Alma Maniére for Air Jordan with the Jumpman symbol as well. I think that this is definitely a good touch. And comfort wise, just speaking from my experience with the Air Jordan 3s, the quilted liner definitely pays dividends when it comes to everyday wear. Moving on to the heel collar of the shoe, you're actually gonna find some more of that burgundy snake print all along the heel collar. And the cool thing about this is they opted to leave the heel collar unstitched, meaning that when it comes to styling, you can either kind of let it flop in the wind and really get that hang time, or tie it up as you usually would do with most Air Jordan 1s. This is super reminiscent of the more deconstructed look of the off-white Jordan 1 from Virgil Abloh. Rest in peace, by the way, great visionary, but nevertheless, it's a cool design to implement into an already iconic sneaker. On the lateral side of the heel flaps, you're gonna see something very familiar in terms of the Jumpman Wings logo, but on the medial side, you're gonna find two special messages signed off by Michael Jordan himself. On the right shoe, it says, "Learning is a gift even when pain is your teacher." And on the left shoe, it says, "You have to expect things of yourself before you can do them." So I think honestly, it's a nice way to tie in the whole theme of the shoe. And it's one of those lesser known details where unless you take a closer look, you may not even see it. So definitely a big thumbs up for that. Moving on to the back of the shoe, relatively plain, but I do think it's a good highlight of everything else going on with the shoe in terms of textures and colors. Obviously we have the all cracked sail upper contrasted by a little hit of burgundy snakeskin. And then you can see the actual off-white midsole peeking through. And speaking of the midsole, it is plain, usual Jordan midsole. When it comes to the color though, it's kind of different because it has that oxidized look, but it is different than the sail laces. So with that being said, in terms of a lace preference, I am leaning more towards the maroon just because it is such a discrepancy between the midsole color and the lace color. But nevertheless, you can't go wrong either way in my opinion. Moving on to the outsole, all burgundy, one of the best traction patterns in terms of Jordan silhouettes on the Air Jordan 1. Nike Air hit in the midfoot, and that's really about it for the shoe. Overall, it is definitely a solid shoe and easily one of my favorite Jordan 1 releases of this year, given the quality and the colorway and really that luxury feel. But rightfully so, because it did retail at $200 USD, so slightly higher than a usual Air Jordan 1 price, and with that comes the extra expectations. But with that being said, now's the important question. Do you think that this Jordan 1 release from Alma Maniére is better than the Jordan 3 that released earlier this year? Let me know in the comment section below, and let me know how you think this shoe ranks overall within the 2021 sneaker releases. Is it in your top 10? Because it definitely could be in mine, but there's more heat on the way and there's been a busy year of just solid shoes. But in terms of my opinion, honestly, and I will say this kind of with a grain of salt, the Jordan 3 from Alma Maniére definitely takes the cake in terms of a better sneaker. However, my favorite silhouette is the Jordan 1, so a shoe like this will always have a special spot in my heart. So that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you enjoyed everything else. I'm gonna drop it on foot now just so you can see how it's styled. Let me know what you think of the shoe in the comment section below. I appreciate you as per usual. Like the video if you like the video. Subscribe if you're new, and I will catch you in the next one. Deuces!